Hello everyone and welcome back to another Dare to Game video. Today we are going to be talking about 5 games that I think really could benefit from a full remake in 2021. Now I know many people out there are probably sick and tired of cheap remakes and cash grab remasters, but to be clear, I'm only going to be considering games that are A, good enough to warrant a remake, and B, old enough that it's not just a blatant 3 months of work cash grab that companies are getting so used to these days. I'm looking at you, Bethesda. I also understand and agree, like many of us, that we would rather have some sequels to some of the really excellent games that we've gotten recently, but those are likely still pretty far off. And I think after hearing my pick, you will agree that these games really should be brought into the current generation of gaming. So let's just dive on in and get to it. But before we get any further into the video, I would just like to ask that if you enjoy this content, please be sure to remember to subscribe and ring that bell so you can get notifications for when I upload, which is pretty much every day. And if you like this content, there's a decent chance that you will like some of the other stuff that I make as well. And of course, before I start talking about each individual game here, I just want to clarify what I mean by a remake. I'm not talking about a graphic-enhanced, reshaded version of the same game. That's what we've been getting with all of these so-called remasters recently. That adds no value, and usually doesn't do anything to address what makes these games so dated and hard to enjoy in comparison to newer titles. Don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that these games are unplayable in their current state, at least for the most part, simply that because of how old and dated they are, even the really good things about them are weighed down by some of their worst aspects. So when I say remake, I am talking about a ground-up remake of the game, keeping the story, missions or quests, mini-games, and all of the good gameplay elements, but recreating them in the company's current engine, and fixing any of the standout issues from the old game. I'll get more into specific examples of that as we go along. Just keep in mind, I'm talking about making these games into modern remakes, not graphically enhanced, dated messes. Number 1, The Elder Scrolls IV: Oblivion. So for the first choice on this list, I was conflicted between Morrowind and Oblivion, because I believe that both would greatly benefit from a modern remake. Both were very good at the time, and have some really great things going on for them, namely the story and the role-playing elements. But by modern standards, both look absolutely terrible and have outdated, slow, and cumbersome user interfaces. I decided on Oblivion because, in my opinion, it is the best game in the series. It has the best setting, and has the most interesting replayability. While Morrowind is certainly a great game at what it does, it doesn't appeal to me as much because of its alien and outlandish environment. Oblivion, however, is set in the Imperial province of Cyrodiil, and features an epic storyline that dwarfs that of games like Skyrim. And considering the game came out in 2006, which is 15 years ago, and features laughably bad graphics and animations, imagine what it could be if Bethesda or a third-party developer, like Obsidian Entertainment, could make out of it today, with modern technology. In my opinion, it's a much better game than Skyrim as far as the story is concerned. And given that we likely won't see Elder Scrolls 6 for at least another 6 or 7 years, I think it would resonate well with new fans as well as those of us who have been waiting over a decade for a new game in the series. With this game, the story, as well as the mission structure and the side content, are all great as they are and should remain the same. The user interface is terrible and should be completely redone with a more modern and streamlined menu system. The combat also feels clunky and unresponsive, and should be totally redone. I'm fine with it staying a hack and slash style system, but it needs to be made more smooth and responsive, with real weight behind the strikes. What needs the most work are the character models, the environmental graphics, and all the animations. Honestly, they were actually pretty bad by 2006 standards, and now they look like rotten potatoes. So that's why Oblivion takes my first spot on this list. Number 2, Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. My second spot on this list is actually the reason I decided to make this video. I recently picked up this title on Steam for like $5 and started playing it, and despite having an obvious performance and shader improvement from playing it on a high-end PC instead of a PlayStation 2, it is still a seriously dated and flawed game. Not in design or performance, but in technical limitations. Given the fact that San Andreas came out 17 years ago in 2004, this should not really be a surprise. The whole world and every character model, gun, clothing item, vehicle, and bush is a surprisingly low-poly mesh that almost looks painted on instead of rendered in. The gunplay is slow and sloppy, and the speech animations usually don't appear to show any mouth movement at all, much less any expression, making much of the story elements feel empty, despite some honestly stellar voice acting. Honestly, it's still a playable game, given how good the driving mechanics are, how many open-world side activities there are, and how decent the game's physics are, and most importantly, how great the story is. I fully believe that, to this day, San Andreas is by far the best Grand Theft Auto game as far as characters and story are concerned. It's just a great, very fun game to play, but its age is showing hard. So I say Rockstar gives it a ground-up remake in Grand Theft Auto V's engine, with new character models, movement, and if they want, even Grand Theft Auto V's driving mechanics, because honestly, it's the only other Grand Theft Auto game that did them well. Hell, they could even make an online mode for it. San Andreas' map is smaller than Grand Theft Auto V's in terms of square footage, but in terms of content and variety, it's much bigger. So they should keep the story, the voice acting, and the open world activities the same, but render the whole thing in their most modern engine, with new models for literally everything, and utilize Grand Theft Auto V's combat mechanics. And bing bang boom, the best Grand Theft Auto game ever made is brought into the modern era for a whole new generation of fans to enjoy, as well as those of us who played it back in the early 2000s. Number 3, The Witcher. Both 1 and, to a lesser extent, 2. So this one is the most recent on the list so far, but honestly, probably the one that could use the remake the most. And that is because unlike San Andreas, which is still arguably playable, just really dated, or Oblivion, which is severely flawed and dated, but that's just Bethesda's MO when releasing games. The Witcher is annoyingly unplayable by modern standards, and that is because of the automatic comparison to their later game, The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, which is considered by most people to be one of the greatest games of all time, and by many, myself included, to be the best game ever. The first Witcher game, and to a lesser extent the second one, however, are not. Really, all they have going for them is the game's atmosphere, which in all three games is excellent, the voice acting, which even in the early titles is pretty well done all around, and most importantly, the story, which is pretty much excellent even at its worst moments. Everything else about the first Witcher game sucks. Its combat system sucks. The graphics are potato-y at best, and the isometric or close over-the-shoulder perspectives are vomit-inducing trash. I tried playing these games again recently because of my immense love for The Witcher 3, but I couldn't because of how bad they are by modern standards. My suggestion here would be the most aggressive ground-up remake so far. I would honestly just put both of them together into one game. And the reason for that is because although the first Witcher game had a decently long campaign, the second one was actually surprisingly short and closed off. So I would just combine the stories into one cohesive experience, but I would build a single open world like The Witcher 3 has, and I would integrate the story into it, all with The Witcher 3's combat system, exploration system, fast travel system, potion and crafting system, all of it made in CD Projekt Red's most modern engine, the one that they will be using for their upcoming Witcher 3 remaster. Despite this video not being in any particular order, I think this one would actually be the biggest deal for me, as I can't imagine being able to experience the story of the first two games with the magical perfection of the third entry in this series. And if you think I'm overselling the vast quality difference between the first two Witcher games and the third one, just bear that in mind as I go through my next couple points. I think this one makes a lot of fiscal sense given how much of the work in writing and the story and designing the environments is already done. And the first two games in the series were not that popular. Their sales were dwarfed by The Witcher 3, so we're talking about a metric ton of new customers that would almost certainly buy this game. Just mathematically speaking, the vast majority of people who played and loved The Witcher 3 have never played the first two games. That's just a basic statistical reality given that The Witcher 3 sold way more than twice as many games as the first two combined. The most recent estimate I was able to find for game sales for The Witcher 1 and 2 combined is about 7 million copies as of 2016, which is not that bad. And that is actually after a decent spike after the release of The Witcher 3. However, as of March of 2019, The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt has sold nearly 60 million copies. Do the math. There is an audience that would pay full price for a remake of the first two Witcher games, and this would certainly go a long way towards repairing CD Projekt Red's reputation after Cyberpunk 2077. At number 4, I put Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. So I think this one is an obvious choice for most gamers that have been around long enough to remember how good this game really was. It's arguably the best Star Wars video game to ever be made, and that's not excluding titles like the 2005 shooter Star Wars Battlefront 2, which I still play to this day, or even the much more recent Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order, which was honestly a pretty solid and fun experience, even if it was ultimately forgettable and really lacks replay value. Knights of the Old Republic, however, just got it right in pretty much every way imaginable. had great story, solid setting, excellent dialogue, fun gameplay, and honestly, for the time, pretty dang good graphics. I know that recently there have been rumors that someone, not BioWare, is working on a new Knights of the Old Republic game. And while this may be super great, I would still almost rather have a modern remake of the original one. It did, after all, release 18 years ago in 2003. I don't have any gameplay nitpicks per se that I would even want them to change. Just remake it in a modern engine with the most photorealistic graphics you can, and utilize modern technology to make the combat smoother and more enjoyable. The thing with this game is, it didn't really have any major glaring flaws, at least not any that come to mind. It's just super old for a video game, and I think it would sell like hotcakes if remade for us today. And at number 5 I put The Legend of Zelda: Ocarina of Time. For this pick I bounced back and forth between quite a few Nintendo classics that I used to love back in the day, but in the end none of them were really a competition for Ocarina of Time. For one thing, I think that to this day it's still the best Zelda game that was ever released. And for another, it needs the least work. It already had a great narrative, excellent gameplay mechanics, and a great atmosphere. All it needs to make it a modern hit is a huge graphical upgrade, and for some of the more floaty movements to be tightened up and made more responsive to be hell of a game. When this game was released 23 years ago in the far off time of 1998, it was honestly a gem. The graphics were super good for the time. The world was surprisingly free and open, allowing the player to approach the game's objectives from many different angles. And the atmosphere was surprisingly immersive. The music, animations, sound effects, and the lighting all make Ocarina of Time a magical experience that really draws you in and keeps you there, all while having a feeling of stakes and urgency, which was honestly pretty rare for games at this time. Honestly, Majora's Mask was pretty good too, now that I think about it. I really tapered off interest after Majora's Mask, but those two games were top tier for me for quite some time. I'm guessing my interest switched when I made the move from Nintendo over to Sony with the release of the PlayStation 2. But I digress. Ocarina of Time slaps, and it would be epic if they remade it today. But that actually does it for today's video. What do you think? Do you think that I'm right about these games, in that they deserve a modern remake? Or do you think classics like these should be left in the past and developers should just focus on making new ones? Also, what games did I not list that you think deserve a remake? Please let me know your thoughts down in the comments section below. But in any case, thanks for watching and have a nice day, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching another Dare to Game video. If you liked this video, please leave a like and a comment. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to the channel. If you like my content and would like to support this channel, consider becoming a member today for as little as $1.99 a month. It makes a huge difference. But in any case, thanks for watching and have a nice day. I'll see you next time.